How you doing? It's your boy CD. And welcome to Fan Nation. Today we're going to talk about one of the most impactful, powerful, and controversial stories in the Marvel Universe. It is not the number one crucial story ever created in Marvel, but it is one of the most impactful. And it is called Secret Invasion. Secret Invasion jumped off globally in 2008 with a crucial crossover in every Marvel title. And that crossover changed Marvel from 2008 until now. And it reshaped everything we thought we knew about the Marvel Universe. Secret Invasion was so impactful that Marvel and Disney decided to do a TV series of it. And the first episode dropped yesterday. That episode was great. I'm going to get into that later on. I need y'all to know that although this is a controversial and impactful event that reshaped Marvel in 2008, I need y'all to understand that this didn't start in 2008. 2008 was just when the funk hit the fan. But I need you to understand that this event really started coming together in the mid-90s, when a group of Super Skrulls called the War Skrulls infiltrated the Shi'ar Empire and took over all the heads of the Shi'ar Empire. They even kidnapped Professor X and took his place. And Professor X became this Shi'ar tyrant called the Warlord. And the Super Skrulls, known as the War Skrulls, almost succeeded in causing a cosmic insurrection. But they were defeated by the X-Men and the Empress of the Shi'ar Empire's sister, Deathbird. Then fast forward to 1999. After saving the universe, the X-Men were on their way back to Earth, but they got transferred to the past by accident. And in the past, they realized that they were on the original home world of the Skrulls, and Galactus was on his way. The X-Men tried their best to save the original Skrull world from Galactus, but they soon found out that that event was a fixed point in time. They could not change it. If you want to fact check it, check out X-Men issue 90 from 1999. Once again, the X-Men tried their best to stop Galactus from devouring the Kree homeworld. But unfortunately, it was a fixed point in time. They couldn't change it. Once the X-Men arrived back in present time, they found themselves being ambushed by agents of Apocalypse. And they were able to stop the attack, but during battle, the X-Men were knocked out, and they were knocked out for about a week. They went back to Earth confused of what really went down, but they eventually started to press on and continue their daily work as X-Men. So then let's fast forward to late 1999. There's a new group of mutants called the Manites. anointed by the agents of Apocalypse, led by his new lieutenant, Death, to stop Apocalypse's new death and the agents of Apocalypse from slaughtering these new mutants called the Manates. Scott Summers formed a new X-Men team called the Astonishing X-Men, which their members were Scott Summers himself, Jean Grey, both their sons, Cable and X-Men, Wolverine, and Archangel. When they engaged this new death, he made light work of all the X-Men. When I say he made light work, I mean, I'm talking about he made light work of the X-Men. Apocalypse's new death was so cold-blooded that none of X-Men stood a chance. Not even the formal death Archangel. After he took out the X-Men, Wolverine was still standing, and they went toe-to-toe in a brawl. But then, Death pushed Wolverine into a corner. But Wolverine had to make a decision of his life to save the Manites and the woman he loved, Jean Grey. Wolverine sacrificed himself. During the autopsy on Wolverine, Professor X found out something very disturbing. The man laying on that table with the life sucked out of him was not Wolverine. It was really a Skrull. And the X-Men wanted to know who else the Skrulls impersonated. In Wolverine 145, the 25th anniversary of the series, it was revealed by the Super Skrull to the X-Men how the Super Skrulls, called the War Skrulls, were able capture and replace Wolverine. A little time after the X-Men came back from the past, a group of the War Skrulls came to Earth with one mission: conquer Earth. While they was there, Apocalypse approached them and offered them his help for their services. He wanted to create the ultimate horseman that he called the 12. And he wanted Wolverine to be one of those 12. So when the agents of Apocalypse ambushed the X-Men when they came back from the past, when they knocked the X-Men out, they replaced Wolverine with a War Skrull. And Apocalypse brainwashed Wolverine and made him his new death. So all the time, the War Skrull was posing as Wolverine, the new death the entire time was Wolverine. A little time after that, a War Skrull that wanted to redeem himself, named Fizz, went to Professor X and told Professor X that the Super Skrulls are trying to take over Earth, and they have aligned themselves with one one of the X-Men's greatest foes, but he didn't know which one. And he told Professor X that the only ones that can stop him are the 12. And that's what started the X-Men prophecy of the 12. The 12 is a big story arc in the X-Men from the late 90s, early 2000s. I'm gonna make a video of the 12 later on down the line. Anywho, Fizz also informed Professor X of a subtype of Skrulls that had the mutant gene. And it was explained the reason why they have the mutant gene because of all the centuries that the Skrulls have tried to make super Skrulls through genetic enhancement. Now, because of that, a subspecies exists. But the Skrulls found them inferior and hunted them down to kill them. So after defeating Apocalypse and stopping him from gaining the 12.
And saving Wolverine from his brainwashed persona, death.
After defeating Apocalypse, Professor X decided to leave Earth with the Skrulls that had the mutant gene to train them on how to use their abilities. He named them Kadri K. But soon, the decision to train the Kadri K and using their mutant ability will soon come bite Professor X in the butt, because him training them became the precursor to Secret Invasion. Yes, people, the precursor or the prelude to Secret Invasion happened back in 1999. In issue 90 of the X-Men. This is why I say everything in the MCU I have issues with. Because a lot of these big events, these big cosmic events, the X-Men played significant roles in them. Just like in Infinity War. How can you have Infinity War without the X-Men? Don't get it twisted, y'all. I'm looking forward to see Disney's version of Secret Invasion. My only thing is, once again, how can you have certain events without the X-Men? That's all I'm saying. I'm gonna ask me doing a video on episode 1 of Secret Invasion, hopefully tomorrow or the next day. So stay tuned. Hey, before I go, you know I love ending the show giving you something great to read. And what I want to give you to read is a book called Star Trek Discovery, Thy Standing. This story takes place after Star Trek Discovery Season 1 and before Season 2. This story takes you on a journey with Emperor Philippa Georgiou as she navigates through her issues being stranded in the Star Trek universe instead of the mirror universe called the Terran universe. It is a great story filled with action and espionage. And it's a story about Philippa being a better woman, or at least trying to. This story is written by John Jackson Miller. And I recommend this story if you want a good sci-fi book to read especially if you are diehard Trekkie like me. Well, that's my time. I want to thank y'all for tuning in. Do me a favor. Hit that like button. And hit that subscribe. And I'll catch you on the flip. It's your boy CD. And this is Fan Nation.